With who you are, you feel great.
What would happen if you manifested the desire to have no desires?
That is the screwiest question we've ever heard. Because it defies all of the laws of the universe. In other words, it's not possible for you to be a focused being. Even one-celled organisms have desires.
What's funny is that like in Eastern thought, there's some of these supposed gurus that say stuff like that, and they're saying, you know, in the desirelessness, your true self arises, and that's the only way to...
In the what?
Desirelessness.
Well, what they're talking about is not desirelessness. It's wantinglessness. It's discord with desire that they're talking about. Because when you say, I desire something, there's an implication that there's something unfinished that is wanted. And we want you to understand that there will always be that which is unfinished that is wanted. But when you're in alignment with where you are, satisfied with what is and eager for more is the idyllic situation. Let's chew over this just a little bit more. Desirelessness?
Yeah, it's...
So you're saying
it's tempting to look because you start to look in there and you start to feel this. You're trying to look into consciousness and see where your own consciousness comes from, whether the sense of I am or this, and you're going to have to drop part of that perceiver, perception, perceived dynamic in order to try to reflect
back
to yourself.
Blah, blah, blah,
is that where we're getting mixed up?
Yeah. Hear this. We know there are a lot of people that have said a lot of things. There are endless religions. And since words don't teach is a very good thing, show yourself this. Just try this for a little while and see what it feels like. You've already done it, so you'll understand this completely, what we're talking about. So do you accept that you are living in a vibrational universe? And does it sort of kind of make sense that you are a vibrational being in a vibrational universe? And have you accepted yet that your emotions really are an indicator? Have you had enough trial and error experience to show yourself that when you're in alignment with who you are, you feel great, and when you're not, you don't? Have you shown yourself that? So if you've come that far, then you can take it all the way. Because now all that you have to do is acknowledge that source energy is on your side and in your vortex. And so life's going to constantly cause you to ask for something. And as you care mostly about how you feel, so you decide, all right, Abraham, I'll play your silly game. I'm going to go to bed tonight, and I'm going to acknowledge that while I sleep, my momentum will stop because my point of attraction isn't active when my mind isn't active. So when I awaken in the morning, I'm going to acknowledge that I'm awake, and I'm going to acknowledge that I'm in a good place, that I'm on a high-flying disc, and I'm going to watch those early thoughts that come. In other words, you can't start yelling at your kids right away, and you can't start worrying about what traffic's going to be like, and don't bring the problem that you had yesterday into day-to-day and think about it. Try to let this be a fresh start, like pushing the reset button. And then do that for a few days until you're showing yourself that you can control your mood because you care about your mood by directing your thoughts into good feeling thoughts, into good feeling things, as general as you can about things that you feel good about. And then begin watching how everything begins to respond to you in a different way. And as you play this game more and more and more, your clarity, it's the momentum of it. In other words, everyone can have a high moment. You can listen to a song, it'll take you right up there, and the next minute you're yelling at your kids again. It's the up and down, up and down, up and down that keeps you from gathering the momentum that we're really talking about. But when you get on that high-flying disc and you stay there deliberately, and then you get on that high-flying disc and you stay there deliberately until you've maintained it enough that through most of the day you're feeling good, and then through most of the next day you're feeling good, and through most of the next day you're feeling good, not worried about slipping from your disc because there's always another day. Esther said to us, Abraham, I refuse to accept that I have to wait all the way until tomorrow morning to get back on my disc when I fall off. You've given us books full of tools. I'm going to use them. So she gets out her focus wheel. She focuses herself back into alignment or finds some way of bringing herself to a place of feeling better. You get so that you care about the way you feel. So as you maintain this more and more consistently, what begins to happen is you begin to feel the alignment that you have with that broader perspective. And your sensation of clarity just goes through the roof. Suddenly you know things that you have no logical reason to know. You just intuitively are moving in the right direction. You find yourself just rendezvousing with things that matter to you. It feels like a magical state of being. It's not magical. It's the way you are meant to feel. So your question is, how did so many of us get so far from that? And we say, because you came into an environment deliberately wanting to sift through the variety in order to define what you want. If you have not been the one who has defined what you want, then there can be no satisfaction in the coming into alignment with it or in the realization of it, you see. You are the creator of your own reality. And when you become that hands in the clay, deliberate creator of your own reality, where you think a thought and you recognize that it's causing a diminishment in the way you feel, so you change it, you augment it, you abridge it, you add to it, you amend it, you deliberately define it, and then you feel the ease within you as you come into alignment, and with that ease then comes clarity. Once you begin becoming a master of this energy alignment, and we are knowing that that's the reason that you've traveled so far to play with us under these conditions, you are the masters of this. You are the ones most logical and most likely to tune yourself to these frequencies and maintain that alignment so that you're walking around in clarity, seeing through the eyes of Source, feeling good about things, being the influencer that uplifts, walking among those who may not understand it, not following them with your empathetic thoughts, not letting them control the vibration of you. Garnering the momentum, the energy that creates worlds, is a huge momentum that you have at your back. Esther's been, she says, it feels like I've got this wave at my back. It feels like all things that are necessary are at my back, and all I have to do is focus myself in the direction of something, and that energy comes forth and the clarity comes. Not somebody doing it for her. That's not fun. You want to define it. You want to find it. You want to find the nuggets. You want to find the nugget, and then you want to align with the energy that provides the avenue, the path for the fulfillment of it. Deliberate creation in physical time, space, reality. It's the best of all worlds, and it's why not only you are here, it's why all of us are here as well, you see. Woo! And anything less than that is unacceptable to you and completely unnecessary. And it's from sloppy, unpracticed thinking. You will never again feel negative emotion and not know what it means. Right now, I'm focused in a way that is so far apart from who I really am and what I really want that I'm experiencing this visceral feeling of disconnection is too strong of word, but I'm pinching myself off. Pinching myself off from what? From clarity of the path. What else? From the feeling of the energy. What does that mean? That means your physical body is not experiencing all of the benefit that it could. That means anybody in your surrounding is not benefiting in the way that they could. Upliftment, true upliftment, is tuning to that frequency and maintaining it consistently enough that when somebody else, which is most everybody else, sort of stumbles accidentally into a higher frequency, you're there ready to rendezvous with them. That's when your teaching moment is. This is a room full of teachers and healers. You're wanting so much to be of value to others. And unless you're on the high-flying disc, you just can't be. And if you're on the high-flying disc and they aren't, one of two things has to happen for you to even communicate at all. They got to come up or you got to come down. And so often, you are well-meaning, you join them on the lower disc, and then you feel the void of not being able to assist them, you see. Really good conversation.
Thank you.